All right, so we've talked about the model and the view, but you also may have noticed the octopus object floating around. Now, what the heck is it doing? Well, as we discussed before, the octopus is what is tying our model and our view together. Now, you may have noticed that the model and the view both never directly talk to each other, and that's by design. Our octopus is the only thing that connects them. I like to imagine the octopus as a sort of buffer, connecting the view and the model, but also letting them move more independently than if they were wired directly together. That means you can change how your app looks without messing up your model code, and vice versa. So the octopus is doing things to help out our view and to help out our model. Let's go through those things. Our addPizza function gets called by the view and adds a pizza to the model. And lastly, tells the view to update itself. Our removePizza function is also called by the view whenever you click on one of the little X's. It figures out what pizza was clicked, and it sets the clicked pizza's visibility to false. And once again, it calls view.render. You may notice these are the only two places that our data object, our model, gets mutated or changed. Once again, the view never changes the model directly, only the octopus. Now we've got two more functions to go. GetVisiblePizzas is a function. It's almost like a tunnel that the view uses to get the data from the model. So rather than the view saying, "Hey model, what pizzas do we have?" the model asks the octopus, and the octopus goes and gets the pizzas. Now, why doesn't the view just do it directly? Well, there are two reasons. First of all, as we discussed before, it's very important to separate out your view and your model. If you don't, you end up with some pretty nasty code as your project gets bigger. But the second reason is that this getVisiblePizzas function doesn't just return the pizzas directly to the view, it actually filters them for us. It takes all the pizzas from the model and it filters them. And it only returns any pizzas where pizza.visible is true. So if we go back over here to our application and you add a whole bunch of pizzas and then you remove a bunch of them, the way the application works is that 1, 2, 7, 16, and 17 in this case, these all exist in the model, but so do all of the other pizzas we ever made. That getVisiblePizzas function in the middle on the octopus is taking all of the pizzas and only giving the visible ones to our view. And lastly, we have our octopus.init. When you call that, it does all the necessary things to get our application up and running. In this case, the only thing it has to do is tell the view to initialize itself. So once again, big picture, if you have your model and your view, your octopus is the thing that connects them to each other. They never talk directly. So all of these functions are different ways of getting between the model and the view.